Can you hold on till Christmas? I should definitely get paroled by then. I'm making sure I don't get into any sort of trouble in here.
Well, I suppose I'll have to hold on, won't I? I can't just desert the kiddies. But I couldn't go beyond that, Pat. Christmas is the limit.
It seems that Chrissy's suddenly anxious to discuss something with us.
Well, I'm very busy. I hope you won't be wasting my time.
No, I won't, Mrs. Davidson.
Well, then.
Well, it's...
Come on, get on with it.
It's a delicate situation, Mrs. Davidson. It's personal, you know.
Well, you can speak in front of Mr. Fletcher. Well, say what you have to say, or I'll send you back to the laundry.
All right. I took it myself, to make myself sick. I'm pregnant.
How about the duty rosters?
Yes, they're fine.
Good, I'll post them.
That was quite a bombshell last night.
Latham? God, I'll say.
What do you think?
Well, for someone who knows how to go about getting pregnant, she's got a pretty strange idea of reversing the process. Enforced vomiting seems a bit ignorant of the facts of life to me.
Yes. An emetic like Ipecac could tend to raise morning sickness to the level of bubonic plague. Oh, speaking of pregnancy, the maintenance work assessment's been approved.
Oh?
Yes, we'll be having some visitors on the premises in the next few days. A work party's coming over from the men's prison. So would you warn our officers to keep an eye on our lot? One possible pregnancy amongst them is quite enough for the time being.
Where will they be working?
Well, mainly on the fence. Nothing serious, just routine. But I'd like to keep them at a safe distance.
Right.
I want to clean up that Chrissy Latham business as soon as possible, too.
Well, Miss Bennett's taking her to see Dr. Miller this morning.
Good. I can't spare any of my officers to play nursemaid to her, and I'm certainly not going to disrupt the routine for one fanciful woman.
You don't believe the story, then?
Oh, she could be conning us.
Yeah, well, it's bad enough having her here at all. What with her effect on Meg?
Mm. Oh, I'd like to see Meg as soon as she arrives.
Right, I'll send her in.
A doctor.
All right, Latham, on your feet.
Oh.
That's quite enough. You're not dying.
Where would you know? I could have died in the night for all you care.
With all that noise?
No.
Now, come on. You're going to see the doctor now.
It's not before time, either. Fancy leaving a sick person alone all night without any medical attention. You could have called the doctor yesterday. It's sick. Cruel. That's all I can say.
If that was all you could say, I, for one, would be very grateful. Come on. What are you doing here, O'Connell?
Excuse me, Miss Bennett. I was wondering whether I could see the doctor.
Why? What's wrong with you?
I'm just not feeling very well.
The doctor hasn't got time to waste with hypochondriacs, O'Connell. Nor have I. If you're fit enough to be wandering the corridors, you're fit enough to work.
But, Miss Bennett...
Get back to the laundry where you're supposed to be. Come on. It's a lot of fun, isn't it? Folding sheets.
It's a bit monotonous.
You could always pretend you was doing it at the Southern Cross.
Doing what at the Southern Cross?
You know, changing sheets and being a maid.
Oh, yeah, that'd really make the time whip past, wouldn't it?
Well,
you know, I reckon she could have disappeared right down the plug hole.
Now, what are we talking about now?
Chrissy.
Oh.
She could have vomited herself out of the joint.
Oh, come on, but if it was that easy, I would have tried it years ago.
Now, you know what I mean. She didn't come down last night, and she didn't come into breakfast this morning.
She could be in the pound.
What?
I don't know. There's not many places a person can disappear to around here.
Yeah, well, good luck to her if she is, the bitch. Setting me up like that. Solitary's about the only place she'll be safe, I can tell you. Oh, hello, love. Did the doc give you something?
No.
Well, what did he say?
Oh, I didn't see him. Miss Bennett wouldn't let me.
Oh, sure.
Oh, God, she's a rat.
Oh, that's not fair, Pat. You obviously need something. I mean, B said you didn't sleep a wink of sleep all night.
Oh, I was just overexcited seeing the kids.
Yeah, well, it's real tough.
Oh, good old vinegar. Now, she really knows how to get on your good side, doesn't she?
I'm okay. At least I saw the kids.
Yeah, what about that boy in Pentridge, though? Have you heard anything yet?
No.
And
and I thought... Angela Jeffries said she'd try and get a message to him.
Maybe she couldn't.
Poor David. I just want to tell him about the divorce. I mean, he's got to know. It's only right he knows.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, if I could just talk to him, explain.
Come on, mate. You don't want to think about that anymore.
No. Oh, by the way, I saw Chrissy Layton.
No, you don't say.
Vera was letting her out of solitary.
See, I told you.
Well, well.
Vera didn't seem to mind Chrissy wanting to see the doctor.
Hmm.
See, I was right. She's been vomiting all night.
No, that's the funny thing. She looked really well.
Oh, the plot thickens. Hey, listen, Pat, did you hear him say anything?
What?
Oh, I don't know. Anything.
No, just Chrissy whinging a lot.
Well, what about?
Wanting to see the doctor, that's all.
Well, what about Vera?
No, nothing.
Come in. Oh, good morning, Meg.
Morning.
I'm just having some tea. Will you join me?
Thank you.
Please sit down.
Good.
How are you today?
I'm fine, thanks.
How's that? Not too strong, I hope?
Well, it looks lovely.
Well, come on, Erica. I'm well aware you didn't ask to see me just to pass the time of day. Now, what's going on?
Nothing, really. It's just that...
Something to do with Chrissy Latham?
Well, yes. Did you know why she was transferred back here from Barnhurst?
No, not exactly.
Well, there were rumours she was playing around.
Playing around?
Yes, she was found a couple of times in the men's block. No one knows how she got there or what she was doing there, but it was enough to warrant her transfer. Yesterday, we found out she was the person responsible for breaking into Dr. Miller's office. She claims she's pregnant, and she stole the drugs in order to terminate the pregnancy.
You're joking.
I'm only relating her story.
Well, I'm well aware of just how far she's prepared to go to get a man, but I mean... I just can't see it happening.
Well, neither can I. It's more likely she's trying to get herself isolated from the other women.
Well, that wouldn't surprise me. She's not at all popular. Is she going to have a pregnancy test?
Yes, just to be on the safe side, but I'm pretty certain the result will be negative.
Sit down.
I am, aren't I?
I'm afraid you are, yes. I'd say at least 8 weeks.
Yeah, I knew it.
I shall want a blood test to send to pathology. Look, I've no intention of asking you how you managed it, but I would like some idea of what you plan to do.
Well, what do you reckon? What can I do? You're going to have to organise an abortion for me.
I'm obviously wasting my time. Take her away, Mrs. Barry, and keep her apart from the other women.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson. Well, come on, Latham. Let's go.
Sometimes I think we should be allowed to torture them.
Yeah, the Crim's first commandment. Don't lag.
Well, this is slightly different, Mr. Fletcher. The father, even though he is a criminal, is, I dare say, entitled to some say in the matter.
But if Latham's telling the truth about not knowing who the father is, there must be several men involved. Could be anybody at Barnhurst.
There are some men at Wentworth, too.
That is quite uncalled for, Miss Bennet. Dr. Miller's report clearly states that she is at least 8 weeks pregnant. She's been here less than a month.
Yes, I'm sorry.
I agree with you, Mr. Fletcher. If Latham is telling the truth, then this scandal could be one of major proportions. My main concern at the moment is to keep the affair from becoming public knowledge.
Oh, but there'll have to be an inquiry, surely.
I'm well aware of that.
But what are you going to do?
I shall make out a confidential report to the department and let them deal with it. Obviously, any inquiry will deal mainly with Barnhurst. I don't want any of our officers implicated in any way, not even by suggestion.
Yeah, the newspapers would have a field day.
Exactly. So, until we are reasonably safe from any gossip or speculation, we'll have to tighten up our own security. There will be no visitors without my express permission, and even then, all visits are to be closely supervised.
I think we should be able to keep a fairly tight lid on it. Now I'm glad you're back. Not quite sure how I would have handled a situation like this.